It's always a big challenge when you have well-known names transforming into other well-known names. And then on top of that, we have a very big cast. And so we have a lot of people, I think, you know, somewhere in the 90s of cast, and about half of that are all lookalikes in some way. And then we have designing our three leads is Kazu, who is, you know, without a doubt, and every makeup artist across the world, I mean, he's the best. So to work with him is always an honor, and a great bar, a really high bar. And I was particularly honored that he asked for me to be here. So that was, I mean, I was kind of shocked. It's our first time working together, but so pleased. He's amazing to work with. So it's good to work with someone whose bar is that high, and the details, you know, I like to think that mine is too. So, you know, so you have these great makeups designed by him, and then we have other makeups that you know, are also prosthetic makeups that are coming out of, you know, me and my department to create it and to make everything look like it's in the same hands. After I was hired on this job, and, you know, the first thing is, who's cast? And it took quite a bit. You know, our casting didn't begin to get finalized until right before we started filming. So we were doing a lot of stuff as we were filming and grabbing. I mean, I knew the people that I felt we would have to do things to make them special. You know, like Rudy Giuliani, he's such a specific look and, you know, doesn't have a lot of hair, so we knew we couldn't just style it to make it work. And Rupert Murdoch being another one. And so we kind of knew we were going to have to do stuff along there anyway. And so as soon as they were cast, we had them go get a life cast. We've used different, you know, I think Rudy was in Atlanta, so we started there, had the life cast sent to Los Angeles, and then began that process. And again, trying different stuff, you know, I mean, the actor playing him, we have to bring these things together. It's quite a bunch of large pieces. We have Kayla, who's Margot Robbie, and she's probably the only person in this who has a true arc, a physical arc that we see her go from one person to another. So we really, and she doesn't wear any prosthetics in it. And we do just kind of beautiful, simple makeup techniques to transform her from one to another, following into how her story is being told and how she's being affected as a human being on this and how she'll end up that way. And we are using makeup. You know, the anchor look is so famous for its lashes and, you know, heavy skin and heavy eye makeup and that flawless look of the Fox girls. Most of their lips were all pretty shiny, not really dark or red or anything like that, but very shiny and lots of lashes. And, you know, it's not unlike us to, like, stack three or four sets of lashes on top of someone just to be able to get the look that we need. Shirley's is very collaborative. She weighs in. She has an amazing eye. She's very good at makeup herself. So, you know, it's great to work with someone like that because they know a lot. So again, you know, here I am and you work with Kazu, who's great, and Shirley's, who's great. And then so it really, it's fantastic because everyone comes to the table with their highest bit that they can come. But I think we felt that we discovered that to get the look that looks like Megyn Kelly didn't need to be changed a lot. We felt it would be too confusing. You know what I mean? To have all the prosthetics and to get that look, we felt like we get a look that's locked for her at work. Her work look, her on-camera look, excuse me. That was lovely. Her work look, her on-camera look. And then when she's at home and other stuff, it's definitely not the lashes, and it's definitely a different look for that. But it didn't feel like it needed it, and I don't think her character went through that. She was always very business through the whole thing. You'll find it in her performances. It's quite beautiful. Jay has been so supportive, and yet he hasn't really had to be a part. I mean, I've gone to him through every character and everything we're going to do, and he's just been so supportive through it all. And a dream and easy to work with. He comes in the trailer when he can and talks to the actors, and he makes the process, he supports in every way, meaning he really wants everyone to bring everything to the table, and yet he's in that same place of let's find out what's really right, not necessarily to be so exacting, but to find out what's right. And what's interesting is that we are seeing the same thing. So it's just been a beautiful ride.